Good afternoon, everyone, and thanks for everyone coming out to this balmy celebration of our American heroes, our veterans. Want to start out first by saying the Pledge of Allegiance. So if everybody could stand, salute the flag. Gentlemen, remove your hats. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So it's our honor at Resurrection Cemetery to hold this very important event every year. And it's a great honor for Tim Burrows, our cemetery director. Myself, I'm Frank Oldani, I'm the director of family services here at the cemetery. And we're always honored to have dignitaries for this special service. And this year's no exception. We have, starting off with our Township Supervisor Bob Cannon, and we're lucky to have our United States Representative Andy Levin here today, and then the staff from the Township Council Office always come out and support our events for our veterans every single event, no matter rain or shine. And we appreciate all of that. So at this point, to keep it short and sweet, I'm going to turn the mic over to our Township Supervisor, Mr. Bob Cannon.
Please be seated. Well, good afternoon, and thank you for attending our annual Veterans Day program. Tim Burrows, Frank Aldini, Don Tench, I didn't see her today, and all the staff at Resurrection, make it comfortable. No matter how bad the weather, the flags flying are beautiful in the snow, and VVA 154 doesn't get any better. The men and women who work out of that organization do so much for their comrades as well as everyone returning home. I'd like to talk a little bit about tradition. Tradition contributes a sense of comfort and belonging. It brings families together and enables people to be with their friends. It reinforces values such as freedom, faith, integrity, a good education, personal responsibility, a strong work ethic, and the value of being selfless. These values are what make our country strong and help us to reinforce generation after generation our responsibility of remembrance. If it were not for this important tradition, we would not be here. Instead, you could be warm in your homes with the fire on. You could be much more comfortable. But you know the men and women we're here to honor today deserve this. They deserve our attention. They deserve this tradition. We choose to be here to reflect on what it means to serve under any and all conditions. Veterans Day is a special holiday, and those who earn that title of veteran deserve it. And right now, as we gather here today, thousands and thousands of soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guardmen are on the job around the world protecting us, probably in a lot worse weather than this. We celebrate our veterans and thank all of them for their service. Veterans, please tell us your stories. Let people know what you've done so we can see the many faces of military service and appreciate the personal service of their neighbors. The more we talk about what we do and the impact of military service on our lives, the better we are to hold it up as an example of excellence, and the better we are able to reinforce this important tradition for the next generation. Color Guard. Christina England.
Will you please stand for the national anthem?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you. Please be seated. Invocation by Ron Dirtle. Ron always has a wonderful message for us.
Thank you, Bob. This time, the time has come to say farewell as a chaplain of Vietnam Veterans, Chapter 154. My wife and I have purchased a condo in Florida where we'll be spending our winters as snowbirds. Therefore, I will be gone quite a few months and not able to be the full-time chaplain for our chapter. As you may or may not know, I recently had to have emergency open heart surgery on June 10th of this year. The surgery was life-threatening and very involved, comprising a quadruple bypass, mitral valve replacement, maze procedure for atrial fibrillation, and to close a hole the size of a quarter in the top chambers of the heart. The surgeon was reluctant to even attempt the surgery for fear I would die on the operating table. My wife insisted he try, no matter what the odds were, because she knew I was born again in Jesus Christ. And if I did die, I would be in heaven with my Savior, Jesus Christ, the moment my soul was not present in my body. She and I had the peace that passes all understanding as born again believers. During this turbulent time, we were in the midst of purchasing our Florida condo and applying for mortgage insurance, real estate agents, and the works. I'm happy to say the good Lord worked it all out, and we closed on our real estate on July 8th. As your chaplain, it was my concern that all my brothers, the Vietnam veterans of this chapter, would know that when you die, you are going to meet God face to face. And if you want to be admitted into God's heaven, you have to do it God's way. For Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. You see, there is only one way to ensure eternal salvation and perfect communion with God, and that is through his son, Jesus Christ. If you're interested in how to get it done, it's easy as ABC. Admit honestly to God that you have sinned and disobeyed him. Believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross and rose again. His blood was shed to pay for your sins. Choose to trust that Jesus alone for the forgiveness of your sins. Now I'll give the invocation. O eternal God, our shepherd, with you we shall not want. With you we shall lie down in green pastures and rest beside still waters. Though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you we shall fear no evil. For you are with us, your rod and your staff comforts us. We gather today to honor the men who have walked through that valley of the shadow of death. Though they walked through that valley long ago, the valor and selflessness with which they trod the valley will live in the annals of American history always. We remember their comrades in arms who never returned from that valley so many years ago. They did not lose their lives, they gave them. They offered up themselves for their country, their families, and their buddies. Their sacrifice shall never be forgotten in the story of America's great crusade against tyranny. We remember, too, the families of these men interned in their own country while their sons, husbands, and fathers fought to vindicate their names and reputations. We thank you that you are a God of righteousness and justice, who rights wrongs and brings light out of darkness. You may be glorified today as we confer recognition, unjustly we held, long overdue. May you be honored, even as we honor these brave men, their families, their comrades who are not here today. O God of hopes, our shepherd, we commend this ceremony to you. Amen.
Thank you, Ron. You're going to miss all this snow, but we're happy that you get to retire partially to a sunny state. Ron has had many, many wonderful sermons up here. We will certainly miss your guidance. Our guest speaker, retired Army Colonel Brian McVeigh.
Good morning. How y'all doing? Don't be intimidated by the size of the binder. I'm almost blind. Good afternoon, Congressman Levin, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to join you today in celebration of our nation's observation of Veterans Day. Some 244 years, our citizens of this great nation have answered the call to duty. From Lexington to the global war on terrorism, from the snow-covered hills of the Ardennes to the mountains of Afghanistan, American warriors have always been willing to fight for freedom as we embrace and enjoy today. It's right and fitting that we honor these men and women who have served in our armed forces, past and present, so I thank you for participating in today's ceremonies. Soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marines, and Coast Guard men follow a way of life and a system of values that are central to all they do. After serving 26 years in the Army, I am intimately familiar with the warrior's ethos. It's a fundamental spirit across our armed services that influence our beliefs, our customs, and our practices. We will always put mission first. We will never accept defeat. We will never quit, and we will never leave a fallen comrade behind. This ethos is tied directly to the seven Army values of loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. Veterans Day, pardon me, Veterans Day means different things to different people for a variety of reasons. For my family, it's an important day because not only did I wear the uniform, but so did my bride, Julie. My dad, six of my brothers and sisters, and I currently have seven nephews and nieces that are wearing the uniform of our nation. It's important to us not only because we have worn these uniforms, but the memories we hold dear for our comrades in arms. Take a second and think of the veteran that you know, who has served previously or is serving today. It may be a veteran that is young or old, who is living or who has passed on. Regardless of that person's rank, and regardless of their branch of service, regardless of how long they served, I bet you it's not hard for you to think of a veteran that personifies these values. While each of our services have their own individual values, perhaps the prevailing trait that's common to all of the services is selfless service. Our veterans symbolize the nobility of sacrifice and selfless service by answering that call. The call to duty, to serving wherever they are needed. They understand and appreciate the dedication to something much greater than self. They believe their service makes a positive difference. It's right and fitting to honor these men and women today. They deserve our gratitude. Men and women who have served as members of the United States Armed Forces are extraordinary Americans. They represent the very best of our nation. They come from many generations and varied backgrounds. They come from massive cities to tiny villages. They have charged across the battlefields. They have fought on the high seas. They have patrolled over the ocean skies, open skies. In conflicts around the world, our veterans secure the priceless gift of liberty for millions. These heroes are the standard of bravery and idealism for mankind, and have earned the deep respect and admiration of a grateful nation. Today, the men and women of our armed forces follow a proud tradition that has been handed down from the patriots who served before them. They're protecting our nation, advancing the blessings of freedoms, and laying the foundations for many peaceful tomorrows. America's past and present veterans have helped us immeasurably grow to a stronger nation. We will be forever grateful for their love of country, duty, and honor. That's why are we here today. It's right and fitting to do so. When he established Armistice Day, President Wilson sought to commemorate the end of the World War and to mark a lasting peace. President Eisenhower changed the name to Veterans Day in the aftermath of World War II, solidifying the purpose of that day to express gratitude to our service members. We honor our past and treasure the accomplishments of those who served before us. When the guns stopped firing on November 11, 1918, almost 5 million Americans had served in that war. The last of the World War I veterans, Corporal Frank Buckles, passed on in February of 2009, almost a decade ago. And 16 million Americans who served in World War II, less than 500,000 are with us still today. Corporal Buckles, his comrades in arms, their sons and daughters who served in the war that followed the war to end all wars, represent the last of these great generations that brought our nation to the center of the international stage. Veterans Day is a day, is an opportunity to provide us great opportunities to learn from the service members. Veterans, young and old, have extraordinary services and stories. In the light of the passing of the World War II veteran, we take time to hear their stories of these veterans have to tell, stories that will keep them alive in our hearts long after they have walked their last post. American veterans are such a special group, men and women who place country above self, have placed safety and security of others before their own. They have preserved our world, our way of life, and our freedom, and have shown us the true meaning of sacrifice and citizenship. There's much we can learn from them. By sharing their firsthand experiences during some of the most proud and dramatic moments of our history, veterans of any age can help us inspire and educate. In a few moments, we will witness a ceremony to honor our nation's veterans, symbolizing the dignity and the reverence we all share for them. We render honor to those who have served in war and in peacetime, and those who have died paying the ultimate sacrifice for our nation. We honor our comrades who've passed on this year. It is right and fitting that we keep their memory alive by what we do here today. Before I wrap up, the appreciation we show veterans formally doesn't need to end when we leave the ceremony. We should continue long after the crowd dispersed this afternoon. We can show our gratitude less formally in many ways on any day of the year. I encourage all of us to keep that in mind as the occasions present themselves. After all, veterans don't serve for glory or march in victory parades. They serve to protect us and our great nation. And while they might be embarrassed to say so, they would truly appreciate a simple handshake or a thank you for your service. It means more to them and their families than you will ever know. So I guess maybe this is a good place to conclude with these words of comradeship, respect, and recognition. Each of these words reminds me of our nation's veterans, as I hope they do for you. It's right and fitting that we do so. Again, thank you very much for joining me for today's Veterans Day occurrence. May God bless you, our troops, our veterans, and the United States of America. Thank you.
Thank you, Colonel. We are honored to have our congressman here today. I had the pleasure of working with his father for many years representing Clinton Township. And now Andy has taken that spot, and we're pleased to have him here to honor our veterans with us today. Andy Levitt.
Thanks, Bob. Well, one thing I haven't learned from my dad yet is you need a winter coat in both D.C. and at home, but I'll figure it out. Well, it's truly an honor to be here to honor our veterans today. We need to honor all those who are serving us right now, protecting our freedom. We need to honor all of those who have served and are done and are back with us in the community here in Clinton Township and throughout Michigan's 9th District. We have 34,000 veterans living amongst us. And Colonel, you're right, we need to thank every one of them if we could every single day. And then of course, above all, we need to honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice. And I just want to take a moment to focus on the folks who never give up on our prisoners of war and those missing in action. Just last month, I had the incredible honor of participating in the burial of Private First Class Reserve Kenneth Lukens, who was from Mount Clemens and who died on the third day of battle in a little atoll in the Gilbert Islands in the Pacific Theater. And in May, folks found, doing amazing research, found a row of burial plots that the comrades of those soldiers had made on one of these islands that had been forgotten. And they brought him back, and I got the honor to meet his first of kin, who's still alive, a nephew, and Kenneth's mom's sister had named her son Kenneth after the lost soldier. And here he was, and his uncle was back, lost no more, buried where he belongs, in the land of the free and the home of the brave. So let's tip our hats to those who always keep looking for the prisoners of war and the missing in action. It's something that we all need to dedicate ourselves to. You know, basically, I feel like our job in Congress is, yes, to thank our veterans for their service, but we need every day to do more and take care of them in the way they deserve, with health care, with other benefits. That's the least we can do for our veterans once they're home. And I just want to mention a couple of problems that we're working on. We did pass a bill at long last to do honor to the Navy veterans who were victimized by Agent Orange, but who were never able to get treatment until now, veterans of Vietnam. We still have a huge problem with our veterans taking their own lives. 22 every day in our country. We've passed five bills this Congress to work with them, but we cannot stop until we stop veteran suicides. We need to tell them we love you, we need you, and we need to do everything we can to get them the care they need so that we don't lose so many of them. And finally, homelessness. We don't have exact numbers, but we have something like 1,000 homeless veterans in our state. What a shame. And with our colleagues in the state senate, in county government, in local government, we need to work every day to reach out to homeless vets. It's about 1 in 9 of all of our homeless people in Michigan, and do whatever we can. So let's all pledge never to give up, to serve those who served us. It's the least we can do. It's an incredible honor to be here with you. The worse the weather, the more our commitment to our veterans. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Congressman. Now we're going to have the dedication of our honored veterans and their tablets by VVA 154.
Bennett J. Ailes, Korean War. Joseph Ailes, Korean War. Salvador D. Ailes, World War II. Army, Carlton S. Allen, Iraq, 2006 to 2008. Air Force, Gerald P. Blanchard, Airman First Class, 1954 to 1958. Antonio Clapparo, World War II.
Frank Calabro, Korean War. Vincent Concessi, Korean War. John J. DeAnna, Jr., World War II. Army. Oswald V. DeRiker, Korean War. Marine Corps. Lawrence G. Gorski, Vietnam era, Navy. Norman D. Kampfer, World War II.
Clarence A. Klokowski, World War II Army, Bronze Star. Floyd K. Klein, United States Army, Sharpshooter. Alan A. Lettrick, Vietnam Sergeant, United States Marine Corps. Philip Maniskalik, Jr., Lance Corporal, United States Marine Corps. Paul A. Marion, United States Marine Corps, Korean War. Army, John Matthews, Jr., World War II.
John F. Mosier, World War II. Army, Marion Ogrodnik, World War II. Dominic Ruggiero, Korean War. Sal M. Vitale, World War II. Army, Thaddeus Walilko, World War II. Army, Ronald J. Witkowski, Corporal.
Ready. Kim Johnson. Please be seated. Thank you to our guest speaker, Colonel McVeigh and Andy Levin. We appreciated that very much. Part of the tradition that we have here in Clinton Township is that we celebrate every opportunity to honor our veterans. And we have the greatest partners in the world with the VVA 154 and Resurrection Cemetery. We have another tradition also. In 2010 and 2015, we applied for the Wall That Heals to come to our community. And we received it. I have good news. We applied again, and we were one of very few who are going to have the Wall That Heals come to Clinton Township, come to Michigan. There's only two communities, and we are one of those. So this will be the third time in 10 years that we'll have the Wall That Heals. The wall that you saw in 2010 and 2015 has been retired. The new wall is actually 50% larger. So it's 3/4 the size of the wall that's in DC. I hope all of you here today will take the time to visit the wall. It is the wall, I'm sure, that the veterans are going to want to do that they've done in the past, as they do out here, as they remember the POWs and MIAs. They have vigils, and they take care of their own. To all the veterans here today, all of us sincerely appreciate your service and your sacrifice. Thank you to all of you who chose to honor veterans today. Christina?
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesties above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and cry good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Thank you, Christina, and thank you all. That concludes our ceremony today. Same time, same place, next year.